Good morning. Today is the second online lecture for Business 106. We are going to continue with the same activity which we had done in the lecture 1. We are going to cover activity number 1, which is in page number 7 and 8 of the course material, which has been already uploaded in Moodle. Today's class has two main learning outcomes. We are trying to achieve these two learning outcomes for this activity. Number one, we are trying to see that you will be able to perform some calculations in Excel using formulas, and we are going to use some functions in Excel for calculating some average, maximum and minimum. Functions are built-in buttons, or functions are something which is already available, feature which is already available in Excel for making the calculations easily. So the second part is very easy to do. The first part is actually going to give you the concept how calculations are done in Excel. So this is our learning target for this lecture. Now, to start with this particular activity today, you have to open the same activity which you have done yesterday. Yesterday I remember that I saved the file with the name exercise number 1 N. So now I opened the file in front of you. The same file which we created yesterday is now appearing in your screen. So now using the screen I am going to actually make the calculations. If you want to refer to the activity which I am talking about, it is in page number 7 and 8 as I already told you. This is the activity which I am doing now. Okay, the handout is already available with you. So in order to make it more clear, I am just removing this unwanted file so that you can see it very clearly. Now you can see here, this is the table we typed. I already told you in the last class, we have finished from 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15 we have done. Today we are going to start answering from question number 4 and we will cover up to question number 9. So the first question, let me see what is the question. Calculate profit. I will show you how to do it. First, the most important challenge which our students face in attempting in any exam or in any activity given in the class is that they don't read the questions carefully. So my friends, please make a very clear habit of reading the question first very clearly. Calculate profit for each month. So you see here, we have the profit. Here we have the profit which is here, and you are going to calculate the profit. When you are going to calculate the profit, you are actually going to calculate for how many months? From January to June you want to calculate the profit. Also, you see in this activity we have tried to help you by giving a hint. Hint is nothing but we have given you an idea what you should do. So profit is nothing but sales minus expense. Sales minus expense. That means here you have 140,000 and here you have in expense 125,000. So 140,000 minus 125,000. That's what is actually the profit. See, in mathematical formulas, do not do it blindly without understanding it. Most of the students face problem in mathematics or mathematical calculations because they don't want to understand the idea clearly. What is profit? The sales price or the sales that you have achieved, and what are the expenses that you made in a particular month? The sales minus expense will give you the profit. So I think it's pretty clear for every one of you now. So please try to see how I am going to do that one in Excel. Now you see, this is our Excel sheet. As I told you, please see that you can write the formula here, or you can write the formula in this. This is called the, this is actually called what? Functions, or we can actually use the formula bar. You can type here equal to. Equal. Whenever you are going to write a formula manually, you will start with a first symbol or notation equal. Equal. After that, what you have to do is that you are going to calculate the profit. The profit is going to be calculated by, see, if you are not very clear, you want to write it here also, it's okay. You want to calculate the profit. So click on the place where you want to get the answer. And then you just write equal. See, the same equal comes here. So it's better that you write in the place where you want the answer, equal. And then what is the formula? Again, if you want, you can just refer to it here. Sales minus expense. Sales minus expense. That means what? What is sales? You no need to type the number here. You just have to click on this particular cell. You can see the cell address is coming as C, and this is what? 3. So cell address is C3. So now you have C3. So that is sales. Now I am going to press minus, because sales equal to the profit equal to what? Sales minus, I am going to click on this particular cell, which is nothing but B3. See that the formula has come here, C3 minus B3, and this is C3. If you can see the color, this is blue C3, this is red B3. So now you can see the formula here, equal to C3. You are calculating profit. How the profit is going to come? Sales, which is C3, and expense, which is B3. C3 minus B3. After you do it, just press the enter button in the keyboard. See, now you got the profit for the month of January. So now let us do it for the next month. So how you are going to start, my friends? I know you are very clear now. Try to answer this question by yourself. I give you just 2 seconds, 3 seconds to think over it. If you are ready, you can just take a paper and see what should be the formula. You start always the formula with equal, then sales, and then minus expense. So you can see now, before it was C3, B3. Now it becomes C4, B4. Why? Because C4 because of this cell and B4 because of this cell. So you see that this is a profit for this particular month, February. Do I need to calculate for every month? No need. After you calculate for 1 month, if you can move the mouse pointer, you can see that if it becomes like a plus, like this black plus, then just try to move it down like this. Try to move it down like this. Automatically the answer will be calculated for all the other 4 months, which is March, April, May and June. So I think now you have answered the first question, which is nothing but calculate the profit for the month of all the month, for each month. That means now we have done this particular question. I hope it's clear. Now let us go to the next one. The next one, first read the question. As I told you, the first part of answering any question is what? To read the question carefully. Calculate the percentage increase for months February to June. I want to calculate how much my profit increased between February and March, between March and April, between April and May, and May and June. I want to calculate, is there an increase in my profit or is there a decrease in my profit? That's my goal of actually finding out the increase. But this increase is going to be given in the form of percentage. I want the answer to be in the form of percentage. That means for 100, how much is my percentage of increase? Now to do this one, what I am going to do is that, you can see here, the hint is given here. Subtract, this is only for the first month, which is February. February profit from January profit. That means what? Whatever the profit you got in February, minus it by January and then divide by the January profit. So you will get the percentage increase. How much is the increase of the percentage of profit between January and February? I repeat again. Now this question is about how to calculate the increase in the percentage of profit. I am going to consider between the 2 months, which is January and February. I got a profit in the month of January. I got a profit in the month of February. I want to see that whether there is an increase in the percentage of my profit or there is a decrease in the percentage of my profit. If there is an increase, it will be a plus number. If it is a decrease, it will be a minus number. So now let us go to the Excel again, and you have seen the formula here. Subtract February profit from this one minus this one and divide by the profit of January. That means what? The current month minus the previous month divided by the previous month. So you will get the percentage of increase. Now let us try to calculate it here again. You can see here, this is what I am going to have here. Now, as I told you, whenever you are going to write a formula, you start with equal. And then, what is the formula? So the formula is not for January. We are calculating for February and January. So we start with February, because we cannot calculate for January because we don't have the data for December. So we have to start from February. So we are just typing here equal. And this is the profit which I got in the February minus, and this is the profit which I got in the month of January. I got a profit in the month of February, which is 18,000 Omani Riyal, and I got a profit of 15,000 Omani Riyal in the month of January. So now I have this profit divided by, I am going to divide it by which one? The profit which I got in the previous month. Now, my friends, you have to be very careful on one thing here. You see that you have here minus, you have here division. So automatically the computer will calculate the division first. But our calculation should first do what? Subtraction, and then do the division. So for this purpose, you have to add a bracket. Whenever there is a mathematical formula within the bracket, that will be calculated first. That means in this case, first subtraction will happen followed by the division. If I don't have the formula, just let us try to see what will happen like this. Okay, just I want to show this is not the correct way. If you are not going to put the bracket, you see what is the answer. This is the answer I got. Is this answer correct? No. Why this happened? You look at the formula here. I did not add the bracket. So what happened? It first made the division and then it made the subtraction. But in original sense, I want first the subtraction to happen followed by division. So I want to give the priority for subtraction. How to make the change? What you have to do is that you have to add a bracket between this one, D4 and D3, and then you can see that it becomes 20%. How it automatically become 20%? Normally, if you see that here, if I don't have, see, I am actually selecting these cells because as I want everything into be percentage, I am going to the format of the number. If I give number, it will be like this. But if I am going to change the format, yesterday I told you how to change it to Omani Riyal. If you want to use percentage, can you see here? This is how the percentage will look like. Now it is actually the number format is in the form of percentage. Now, how to calculate the increase between February and March? Now I think it's very clear for you. I am repeating the step again to reinforce the idea in your mind. Equal. So what is the profit in this month? Current month profit is 22,000. Minus, what is the profit in the last month? 18,000. And then what I do? I close the bracket because I told you our priority is to make first the subtraction. Then I am going to divide by what? The previous month profit. So this is current month, March. The previous month is February. So I want to divide it by the previous month profit. So it is 22.2% increase in my profit. Compared to February, my profit is 22.22% more. Now, let me go to the next one. Since this is little bit tricky, I am trying to do it with you every step so that you will get the idea more clearer. Please, just follow the idea again. Press equal. The current month profit is 22,000. which is D6 minus, I am actually choosing from the previous month, minus. So D6 minus D5, that means the profit which I attained in the month of April minus the profit which I got in the month of March, which is the previous month. I want to make this calculation first, so I just put it within the bracket. Then what I do is that I just divide it by what? I have to divide it by the profit in the March, which is the previous month. Now my profit is just 1.17% increase. The difference between the profit which I got in the month of March and in the month of April is what? 1.17%. Now let us go to the next one. I am now calculating the percentage of increase between April and May. I want to find out the difference between April and May. So now the profit which I got in the month of May is 11,111 rial minus the profit which I got in the previous month is 22,257 rial. See, now I am putting a bracket because my priority is to make the calculation first, to make the subtraction. Then I divide it by what? The previous month profit, which is the month of April's profit, which is 22,257 Omani rial. So now you see, I have faced a loss in my business, which is minus 50.08%. Let me do the last one, because you see, I am trying to do all the calculations for you for this particular step, because from my experience, most of the students don't understand this concept. They just try to do something because they want to see that some answer comes. But please, my friends, try to understand one more time again. The formula starts with equal to, and then I am going to subtract the current month profit minus the previous month profit. Since I want to make this calculation to happen first, I will give a bracket and then I will divide. So this is the comparison between the 2 months, April, May and June. Can you see May and June? So this is, I am finding for June, which is the current month. So I will divide by the previous month, which is D7, and it is the profit which I got in the month of May. So now you can see that what happens. My profit is minus 41.98%. See, in business always there is a chance of profit and loss. So maybe now if you look at the situation, we have coronavirus, there is always a problem which is related to any situation like that, directly hitting the economy, businesses will be down. So something like this has happened, so the profits have reduced. So I hope it's clear. Now let's go to the question here. You can see that we have two questions answered. See, my friends, you can ask your questions in any interactive session in Moodle if you are not clear about this point. I have tried my level best to see that the examples are given in a simple way for you to understand the concept. Do not only think about getting the grades. Grades is only an indicator of your learning. So if you want to get a good grade, it means you should learn very well and you should be a good brand ambassador for Dhofar University. Now let's start the next one. See, 6, 7, 8 are so easy and simple. So I will not take a long time. So let us go for question number 6. As I told you in the beginning, please read the questions carefully. This is what our students lack. They never read the question. They come to a conclusion, it is difficult to answer. Read the question, please. Calculate total sales and total expenses. Expenses and total sales. Where is expenses? It is in this particular column, and sales is here in the third column. This is in the second column and this is in this first column. And you see that we have also given here total. We have also given here total. Total is also there. So now I am going to show you how to calculate total. It is very easy. I want to find the total expenses. Select all the expenses here, highlight them. After that, you see that in the home ribbon, you have this button which is called sigma. In the sigma, if you open, you have the first one, which is sum. Sum means total. Sum means total. So, first highlight, I am repeating again, my friends, because again, what the common mistake our students do is that what? They don't highlight. They just go to the button, auto sum, and say that I don't get an answer. Step 1, select the cells for which you want to find the total. Step number 2, you will go to this button which is available in the home ribbon. Then you will click the sum. Can you see now? This is the total. 816,000 riyal, 775,000 paisa. Now, I want to find the total sales. So, this is how you are going to do. Select these 5 numbers for which I want to find the total. Then I want to go to auto sum. I choose sum. Now this is the total. Now you see that here it is like this. Why it's like this? Because of the alignment. Now you see this alignment is what? Not in center. If you put it in the center, it will become right in the middle. If you put in the left, it is going to go into the left. If you put in the right, it is going to go into the right. So I want it to be in the middle. So now we have calculated the next part, which is calculate the total sales and total expenses, and you see that we have used the function called sum. As I already told you, function is nothing but something which is already available in the Excel. Without you are writing your formula, you just select the cells, click the button, the function will happen, you will get your answer directly. So that is why it is called a function. I hope it's clear for you until now. So now let us highlight this one also, meaning to say that we have answered these 3 questions now. Now please read the next question. Calculate average expenses and average sales. See, I have tried to give you this hint here because I want you not to get confused and worry how to do this one. Hint means a clue, a way which you can just think about it when you have this question. But unfortunately or fortunately, this will not be given in the examination. Do not tell us, teacher, in the exam you did not give us this formula or this method. This is given in the activity for your understanding and to help you out. Do not expect the same type of hint to be available in the exam paper. It will not be available. Because many number of times we know that students come and tell us, teacher, you did not give us this method which you have given in the activity. The activity is for practice and help. The more you practice, you can become more familiar and it will help you to become much better. So please do not expect this hint in the examination. This is for your information, my friends. Now let's go to the next one. Here what I am going to do is that I am going to do the next one, which is to average. You have seen it. So now what is the common mistake many of our students do? Average. Yani they think that select everything. No, this is wrong. This is a wrong selection. Why it is wrong? I included total also. You should not include the total. You should only include the information for the months. This is right. Now after that, you will go to the auto sum here and you will click on average. So this is the average of the 6 months. This is the average of the 6 months. Now I will make it center. I am going to calculate the total sales. I am not going to do the calculation. As you see that the pointer is like this. I am moving it to the end of the cell. And then what I will do is that I will just drag it. When I drag it, you will see that it is also calculating for me the total sales. So not total, see average. It's average. What is average? The average means how many months you have here. 6 months you have. What is the average of the 6 months? Add these 6 numbers and divide it by 6. So this is the average. Now we are going to see the maximum. What is maximum? Maximum means the highest among the 6 months. I want to know which is the highest among the 6 months. That is called maximum. And what is minimum? Minimum means the lowest of the 6 months. So for this one, I will just show the question once again because maybe you don't see the question very clearly. So now this is also clear for you. So let me put a highlight yellow so that you know that we have done 4, 5, 6, 7. Let us go to the next one here. Can you see here maximum and minimum? This is what we are going to do in one shot. So now our focus is going to finish this two. Once I finish this two, we have done the rest of the questions yesterday in lecture 1. If you have any doubts, you can still refer to lecture 1. Why I did not do this one? Because this is calculation part, whereas 10 to 15 is on formatting part. So formatting is very easy. So I just finished 10 to 15. Today I started from 6 to 9. So now let us go to 8 and 9. It is maximum. Maximum means highest expense and highest sales. I want to find out minimum, which means the lowest sales and the lowest expense. So how to do this one? Again, we will open Excel here and I am going to do the same thing. So I will select the data for the first 6 months. After that, I will try to go to the same sigma here and I will choose what? Maximum, M-A-X. It's not given full name. Maximum, max. Max means maximum. Click on this one. 156,000 is the maximum. Is it true? Yeah. 156, 123, 134, 145, 132. Yes, this is the highest. Now, as I found out for expense, I also want to find it for the sales. It's very easy. Drag it. It will automatically come. Now, I am going to calculate for minimum. So, step 1, for any functions to use, first highlight the cells for which you want to do any calculation. Step 2, go to the sigma button. Choose the function that you want, like min. Min is what? Minimum. Now you click on this one, you get the answer here. Now if you can see this 6 months, you will see that 123 is the lowest. Yes, true. Now let's go to the next one. How to copy? Same, just drag it. You will get the answer. Now again, I want to align all these things into center. So I just choose this one. You see that it moves to the center. So now I have calculated these things using function. If you want, I am highlighting it to you to see that this is what I have calculated using what? Function. Those things which are in red are calculated using function. Now you can see that what I have here is actually, I will also make it bold. This is what I calculated now today in the class. And I will give another color. Maybe I will give a dark blue color so that you can see it. These are the things which I found out using formulas and I calculated manually without using functions. So now there is one more thing I want to do also, which is not there in the question, which is nothing but count. It's another function. It's called count. I also want to find out the count. What is count? You know what is counting? 1, 2, 3, 4. We count. So I want to count how many information is there. See, in this worksheet, it is very easy to say it's 5, 6 because it's a small sheet. Imagine you are going to deal with data which is very, very big. So in this case, it is very important to use the count function. So I am going to use this particular all the cells. Now what I will do is that I will go here and I will use more functions and I will use, for example, can you see here? Count is already available here. Just I will give count. I will give OK. So see, there is an error. What, there is a problem with the formula. If you want, you can give OK. Otherwise, what I will do is that I will try to now change this one. See, it's not, it has come to this particular wrong cell. See, for example, what is the original value of the cell? Say I am just taking that from the exercise itself. Sorry for that. It's 125,000. So I am just using 125,000 OMR. 125,000 OMR. It got deleted. So now you see again. So don't worry about it. Just type about this count. And then you see again, I am selecting these cells. And then I am going to the auto sum. And I am just going to give count numbers or more functions count. I just use count numbers. it is 6 because there are 6 months. So if you are going to drag it also, it is going to give the same answer 6. So this is how we are going to do it. So after we have done everything, what is the last step? We have to go to file and then we have to go for save. See, in the calculation of count, there was some error that happened because I moved my mouse pointer by mistake. So don't focus on that part where there was a mistake. Just ignore that part. Just try to see. Again, I will repeat for you count one more time. Since in the beginning we had got a mistake and I don't want to repeat the video again. So what I will do is that I am going to show you how to do count again. Select the 6 cells. Go to auto sum, then just give count numbers. So you got the count numbers, it is 6, and now you have here, you can drag it, it is 6. So now this is what is calculated. If you want to apply colors, it is very easy to apply colors. See, it is not in the question of the exercise, I am just showing you. You can just apply fill. Can you see here fill? You can choose any color you like. For example, I want to apply a color like this, so you can give a color like this. Don't give two dark colors because then people cannot see what actually you are typing. So I'm just giving different colors to make my sheet look better and elegant. So now I'm just using green color for this data. For the total and average, I want to use another color. It's okay, I'm just showing you how to fill colors in different cells and different column, that's what my idea is about. So I am using here yellow. I will use a little light yellow, and then I will just try to use here some other color. So I am just going for another color to choose, which is nothing but I want to have something like in red. Red, I think. Okay, I am just choosing any color. Okay, it's 2 dot. Okay, this is fine. So I apply different colors. Also, I can apply the color here in the title itself. I will try to apply a color like this. Okay, home center, because I think the logo of home center is like green in color, so I just give a green color. It looks okay now. So you have done activity 1 completely. So today's class, you have learned number 1, how to calculate profit, how to increase the percentage of increase of profit. Then you have also seen how to calculate total, average, maximum, minimum and count. So please try to go through this one once again, and if you are not clear about something, do not hesitate. You can always ask me. I will be more than willing to help you out during our interactive session. Now what we want you to do, see, there is another activity which is actually available in the activity. This is now done, activity 1 we finished, which is page number 7 and 8. I want you to now do by yourself, type this data, which is a data which you have to type. Then you will actually do the coloring, change the Omani Riyal, you know it, use Mergen Center, you know it, calculate sum, you know it now, how to calculate saving, I have given the hint. If you are not clear, you can ask me or I will help you later. Then delete the sheet, rename. So there are 12 questions in exercise number 2. So this can be given as a homework, and you have time by the end of this week to submit your activity in Moodle. You have to submit to me both activity 1 and activity 2 by using Moodle assignment submission, which we have been always practicing in our classes. As you know that this is our normal practice to submit the assignments through Moodle every week. So you have to submit these 2 activities to me by end of this week. You will be given some grades for CA based on your submission. Late submissions are not entertained, and also you should understand, do not try to copy your friend's file and give it to me, because the purpose of giving an assignment is to help you, is not to just make you do some work. We don't get any enjoyment by seeing that you have to work hard. We are actually seeing that you have to get the good grades. So in order to get the good grades, this course is a practical oriented course and it needs more practice and training. I hope you understand what I am trying to say to you. So try to complete activity 1 and activity 2 now in this week. In the next week, we will start with activity 3, where I will explain you, and also it's very simple one. 3, 4, maybe we will try to do 3 and 4 in the next session of our online activity. So, but today I have covered now activity 1. I am expecting you to complete both activity 1 and activity 2, and you will submit it to me in Moodle by end of this week, which is nothing but I will open the calendar for you. I am expecting that you will submit it to me by 28th of this month, which is a Saturday. I am giving you time until Saturday. You can slowly try to complete and submit it. I will try to award the marks based on your submission and your correctness. Please do not be lazy and do not think that I will submit it. And also do not try to cheat us by taking the file. It is very easy. We can find it out. Okay. Have a good time practicing with Excel. If you have any questions, we can always be available in Moodle during our class time. You can interact through forum or chat or any other means which is available, or even the WebEx meeting, which is going to be soon configured with Moodle, so that you can get the maximum advantage of online learning at Dhofar University. Stay safe and hope to see you soon in the online lecture 3. Thank you very much. See you again.